Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande. Well, when it comes to background processing in Android, on CodeTutor, we have come a long way. We basically have started with services, intent services, then job intent service, job service and job scheduler, foreground services. Services and intent services were mainly studied from the pre-Oreo point of view, and then we basically moved to a conversation about post-Oreo point of view, where we had to use job intent service and all these other things that we have covered in near past, because some new restrictions were put in Android about how to execute a job in the background. It can get confusing to use all these different things and when to use these different things. To address this very particular problem, Android introduced another powerful API that is called as WorkManager. This WorkManager API is part of AndroidX package, or also popularly known as Android Jetpack package. So let's understand what WorkManager basically is. If you look at the official definition of the documentation, this is what it says: an API that makes it easy to schedule deferable asynchronous tasks that are expected to run reliably. Well, asynchronous task is the most easiest part of this definition, which basically means something that runs in the background. Now the question is, what is deferable and what do they actually mean by reliability? Deferable means you should be able to have a very controlled, tight mechanism to schedule your work. That is, whether you want to run this only one time, repetitive times, and also it should be compatible with the doze mode of the Android devices that we typically see, which is a power saving mode. And then, what do they mean by reliability? Well, reliability means you should be able to run your background works in constraints. For example, you want to run it only when the device is connected to Wi-Fi, or only when the device is charging, or when the device is in the idle mode. So there could be various constraints that have to be satisfied before you decide to work your background task. So you should be able to control these things, and you always want to finish the work that you started. This is important because you want to make sure that the work gets completed even if the app exits, it is not visible on the user screen, and even if the device restarts. So having understood this, let's look into what are the different APIs that WorkManager provides to execute something in the background. To get started, you have this API called as Worker. So this is basically a class which you will be extending. So whatever the thing that you want to run in the background, you will define in this class, which extends the worker class. When you extend, you basically will have some callback methods. Do work gets executed whenever you start the work, and on stop gets called when the work gets cancelled or stopped. And then you have API called as constraint. This is where you want to define various constraints under which you want your task to run. For example, basically the whole set of constraints that you want to define for your background task. And then comes another API, which is a work request. So this is basically an abstract class which contains a lot of configurations. For example, whether you want to run your work as a one-time or a periodic, these kind of settings. And then finally, you have a work manager. It is using this work manager that you actually enqueue your work or cancel a work that is already under execution. So having understood this theory, let's get into a demo. Well, by now you should have become already familiar with this demo. Basically, what we have here is an activity with the two buttons, a start service and stop service. Don't go by the name service, because I have been using this demo since we started discussing the service. In this case, when I say start service, it is start a worker. The first thing that I have done here is I have added the dependency to work with work manager, and then I have created this class called as random number generator. It is pretty much the same class, which is similar to, say, for example, intent service class that we had earlier, in the earlier case, it was the intent service or the job scheduler that was doing the generation of the random number generation. But in this case, it is this particular class that will be doing the random number generation. But the thing is, we have not yet completed the implementation. Let's get started by converting this particular class into something that can be used with a work manager. To do that, you have to extend a class called as worker. And when you extend a class, you have to implement some methods. So here is a method called as doWork. And this is where the implementation of what needs to happen in the doWork will be going. And of course, we will have to have a constructor. We will set the context and then work parameters. Work parameters are basically mechanism using which you can pass any values to the worker class. So that is what the work params basically mean. And then to start initially, let's make m is number generator on is equal to true. And in the doWork method, we will basically invoke start random number generator. And then here we will have to return a object of result. So in this case, I just want to return a success. And other than that, there is another callback method, which is called as onStopped. This is optional, not really needed. But in case if you want to handle something when it got stopped, probably you want to persist the value. When it got stopped, you can do it in the onStopped. There is nothing much to write here, but probably what we can do is we can log something here. I can simply say worker has been cancelled. And that's it. We are done with the implementation of the worker class. All we will do is we will get into the functionality of how to start this particular worker class. Well, to do that, we need two things. One is work manager and the other one is work request. So let me get started by creating a private instance of, say, work manager. And then we also need a private work request as well. And then we will have to initialize them. So work manager is equal to work manager dot get instance, and you pass the context, and in this case you will just write get application context. You can write new periodic work request if you want this work to be run periodically, or you can write one time work request, or you can just create a work request and pass different parameters to that. In this case, I just want to run this background task periodically, every 15 minutes. So what I want to do is new periodic work request, and then it will have a builder. You have to pass the worker class. In this case, it is random number generator worker and class. What is the periodicity? So in this case, it is 15 minutes. So I have to write the time unit is minutes. And then if you want to set any constraints, you can do that. Say, for example, set backing of criteria, set constraints. As of now, I am not doing any such thing. I will basically just build it, and that will give me a work request. And then to start this background task, all I will have to do is work manager dot nq. Of course, there are various other options like nq periodic work or nq unique work, but I will go with the simple one as of now. And I will say, I will simply pass on the work request. To stop work that is running in the background, you have to cancel. And you can cancel in lot of different ways. If there are multiple works, you can cancel all of them, or you can cancel by work ID. Quite a number of options are there. So we will go with cancel by work ID. And how can we get the work ID? From the work request. So work request dot get ID, that will give me the work request ID. And that's it. We are more or less done with our implementation. So what we will do is we will run the code and just observe what happens in the logcat. So I have launched the application. I click on the start service, and you can see that the background thread has started, and after running for 5 iterations, it will basically stop because that is what we had written. Another small modification that we want to do, we want to make sure that if I have explicitly cancelled this particular work, it should not be stopped. So there is another condition that I can put here, that is stopped. So don't forget to put this as well when you are working with the background thread. Well, it will take some time to once again reboot this. However, I have already done this. So let me show you what do I mean by that. When I ran the application on click of the button, this is the timestamp you can observe. So for the first time, it is running at 21:22. And then after 5 times, it stops. And since I have scheduled my task as a repetitive task, it needs to get rescheduled again. The constraint that I have put is 15 minutes because that is the minimum. I mean, this is what you learned even in job scheduler as well. That is the minimum setting that you can set for a repetitive task. Then once again, the same worker gets executed after another 5 minutes. That is, it starts at 30, around 5 minutes difference. And then what I do is I basically switch off the device and then switch it on, and I don't even launch the application. But if you observe the logcat, you will once again see that after some minutes, in this case at 36:23, it once again restarted the background work. If you don't trust this, what you can do is you can download the application from the GitHub and execute it and observe it in the logcat. This is exactly what is happening. So with the work manager, you can be assured that your task is going to run as per whatever the settings that you have done. Of course, Work Manager is more powerful than this. You can do a lot of things. I will talk about them in the next video. So stay tuned. That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.